Greetings, Chewy from ATXTCG bringing you today a booster box opening for Force of Will, a new card game. It just came out in English in the US the beginning of February, and we're at the end of February, so you know, yeah. Anyways, this is the considered to be the second expansion set, called The Castle of Heaven and the Two Towers. This is within the Grimm fairy tale cluster, I guess you want to call it. So basically, a lot of the cards have to do with fairy tales and whatnot. Let's go ahead and take out the plastic. Featured there, I believe it's Lumia and Castle, or Purple, or Darkness in this case. So let's see. First off, I guess it doesn't have any information about... No, here it is. So he says, every pack in here contains 10 random cards out of 105 in the whole set. And that's all the information here. Yep. And as far as the company or whatever, like, you know, how Vanguard is, you know, made by Bushiroad and stuff, I believe that Force of Will is... That's the name of the company. It's Force of Will. And it's from Japan, I believe? Yeah, Tokyo, Japan. Anyways, let's go ahead and open it and see what we get. First off, the packs are kind of all over the place right now. Or maybe that's how they did it. Anyways, let's go ahead and start with this side, and then we'll go to the right side and then the middle side, just because... Something interesting about these packs is that they are actually very difficult to open compared to other card games, especially like Vanguard and Buddy Fights. It's easy. I mean, even Magic packs are easier to open than this. There's a little practice I get used to it, but anyways. So let's see. First off, we've got Oz the Great Wizard, and I'm sorry if you can't, if my camera's kind of blurry and you can't really read it, which well, you can't, but anyways. Mad Tea Party, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, Ebony Devil, Duel of Truth, Evolution of Limits, Guardian of Tower, Magic Stone of Light, and we got one rare in here, Thagua, the Flame Spirit, I believe. So in every pack you can get either one rare or one secret rare and a rare. So I think you can also get, like, sometimes you'll get a rare and a, what do you call them, a ruler in this impact. But anyways, let's go. Light of Lumia, Realm of Evolution, Card Soldier Heart, Demon's Curse, Rena the Girl with Nothing, Spire Shadow Drake, Silver Shoes, Sleeping Rat, Magic Stone of Gusting Skies. This is basically, it's a dual land essentially, like magic terms I guess. You rest for either light or wind, aka white or green. But in this case, white is actually yellow. Anyways, Dreams of Wonderland is the rare. Yeah. In this case, I got a rare that is two rares, one of them being the Magic Stone and one of them being a like typical rare, I guess. Nidhard the Demon Knight, Oz the Great Wizard, Breath of the God, Forced Growth, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, Ebony Devil, Duel of Truth, Almeria's the Levitating Stone. It's a special magic stone that you pay one yellow and rest, target J, ruler, or resonator gains flying until end of turn. And Alhaber, the Tower of Despair, is the regular rare. So far, two special magic stones. Mad Tea Party, Red Bird of Omen, Card Soldier Diamond, Pure Spirit of Fantasy, Heartless Tin Man, Gliding Dragon Knight, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Feet Sing, the Holy Wind Stone, Special Magic Stone, it's pay one green and tap. Then target J Ruler or Resonator cannot be targeted by normal spells your opponent's control until end of turn. So three packs in and three stones. Interesting. Now it's just to open from the top pack. Crossroad of Worlds, Sacred Scepter of Exorcism, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, Forced Growth, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, ooh, nice. Eyeless the Drifter in the World, so this is a ruler. Right here. Basically, to J activate, aka flip over, you pay any number of will. You cannot choose to pay zero. When you flip her over, she has different abilities based on which type of will you used to pay. So if you paid yellow, you do one thing, blue another, purple another, red another, and green another. So that's the first ruler of the box. We've got Dream of Wonderland. So I guess Wonderland's a thing. Since we got the ruler, it can be built. I'm probably gonna have to make this video in multiple parts because I'm barely in like the first third of the box. Guide of Heaven, Endless War, Heartless Tin Man, Gliding Dragon Knight, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, Forced Growth. And the second J-Ruler, here we go, we've got Lumia, the Creator of Hope. And this is Sacred Princess of Guidance is the ruler, and Lumia is the J-Ruler. And we've got March Flare. I believe it's March Flare. No, March Hair, sorry. The H became an F and an L in my eyes with that foil. Summoning Art of Alhazred, Sacred Scepter of Exorcism, Seeking Sky Soldier, Joker's Suit, Cowardly Lion, Star Money, Beowulf the Blazing Wolf, Longinus the Holy Lance, Magic Stone of Water, and we've got Lumiel the Tower of Hope. Yeah, I guess you do. Whenever you get a ruler, you still get a. Whenever you get a ruler card, you still get a regular rare in the pack, so that's good. Nidhard the Demon Knight, Oz the Great Wizard, Ebony Devil, Duel of Truth, Evolution of Limits, Guardian of Tower, Card Soldier Spade, Witch's Dagger, Magic Stone of Light, and another Thagua, the Flame Spirit. A lot of trouble saying that word. Is that a word? Bird's a word. Sacred Scepter of Exorcism, Little Mermaid of the Tragic Love, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, Forced Growth, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, Magic Stone of Flame, and Seeks the Ancient Magic. Rapid Decay, Crossroad of Worlds, Heartless Tinman, Gliding Dragon Knight, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, Yamata no Orochi, the 8 Disaster. So this is a pretty good card, well, in my opinion, because it can attack 8 times, so... Well, it can attack up to 8 times, but yeah. But it's kind of pricey because it's... costs 10 to play, but... there's ways. There are many, many ways. It's SR, so... And then we've got... March Hare. Rapid Decay. Katarina, the Saint of Fantasy. The Queen's Butler. Brandless Scarecrow. Card Soldier Heart. Demon's Curse. Rena, the Girl with Nothing. And Mephistopheles, the Abyssal Tyrant. So, SR. And we've got Alice's World. Wicked Witch of the West, Summoning Art of Alhazred, Joker's Suit, Cowardly Lion, Star Money, Beowulf the Blazing Lion, Beowulf, Longinus the Holy Lance, Laplacia, the Demon of Fate, and, oh my god, Thagua the Flame Spirit, that card. I kind of don't like seeing it only because I always have trouble saying it out loud. But what can you do? Endless War, Mad Hatter, Heartless Tin Man, Gliding Dragon Knight, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, another Mephistopheles, so that's pretty good because I run Darkness, so. Alhabra, the Tower of Despair. Realm of Pure Spirits, Rapid Decay, Evolution of Limits, Guardian of Tower, Card Soldier Spade, Witch's Dagger, Seeking Sky Soldier, we got Grimm, the Avenger of Fairy Tales, SCSR, Magic Stone Flame, Thagua, the Flame Spirit. I guess eventually I'll learn how to say that card. So we're 13 minutes in, let's see, go a little bit faster on these ones. Red Bird of Omen, Realm of Pure Spirits, Card Soldier Club, Shallows Giant Dolphin, March of Saints, Portal of Truth, Whisper from the Abyss, Big Bang Revolution, Magic Stone, and Alice's World. Necronomicon, Light of Lumia, Death Sentence from the Queen, Whirlpool of Knowledge, Breath of the God, Forced Growth, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, it's very common, huh? And Don Quixote, the Wandering Knight. It's the rare. Realm of Evolution, Elder Things, Fell with the Blazing Wolf, Longinus, the Holy Lance, Jump to the Sky, Kusanagi Sword, Seashore Fisherman, Wolf in the Sky, and Stoning to Death, Destroy Target Resonator. I like that. I need that. Endless War, Mad Hatter, Jump to the Sky, Kusanagi Sword, Seashore Fisherman, Wolf in the Sky, Card Soldier Club, Shallows Giant Dolphin, And Magic Stone of Blasting Waves produces green and red. And another Stunning to Death. Yay! Halfway there. We got Oz's Magic, Rapid Decay, Destructive Flow, Dragon Slayer, Ebony Devil, Duel of Truth, Evolution of Limits, Guardian of Tower, Magic Stone of Dark Depth, who they actually need, so that's good. Seek the Ancient Magic. Nithard the Demon Knight, Crossroad of Worlds, Beowulf the Blazing Wolf, Lungeon of the Holy Lands, Jump to the Sky, Kusanagi Sword, Seashore Fisherman, Wolf in the Sky, Magic Stone of Light Vapors, tap for white or blue, Queen of Hearts. That's the, what is it, the rare? Yeah. The foils are kind of like hard to see with my lighting, I'm sorry. They're a little too shiny sometimes. Alright, next we got Light of Lumia, Wicked Witch of the West, The Queen's Butler, Brandless Scarecrow, Card Soldier of Hearts, Demon's Curse, Rena the Girl with Nothing, ugh, Spire Shadow Drake, another dual stone, Magic Stone of Blasting Waves. And we got Stoning to Death. One more to go. One more Stoning to Death to go. Yay. Mad Tea Party. Oz's Magic. Death Sentence from the Queen. Whirlpool of Knowledge. Breath of the God. Forced Growth. Destructive Flow. Dragon Slayer. Like Stone of Darkness. And Alhabra, the Tower of Despair. Guide of Heaven, Necronomicon, Spire Shadow Drake, Sleeping Rat, Card Soldier Diamond, Pure Spirit of Fantasy, Heartless Tin Man, Gliding Dragon Knight, Magic Stone of Water, Magic Stone of Magic Seems Legit, and Sleeping Beauty. I think for the last stack, I'm just gonna show them without saying the names, except for the rares or SRs. Sacred Scepter of Exorcism, Little Mermaid of Tragic Love, Jump to the Sky, Kusanagi Sword, Seashore Fisherman, Wolf in the Sky, Car Soldier Club, Cheshire Cat, The Grinning Remnant, and Seeks the Ancient Magic. So, I think that's how we do it. Is this how we do it? Katarina, the Saint of Fantasy, Realm of Pure Spirits, Spire Shadow Drake, Silver Shoes, Sleeping Rat, Card Soldier Diamond, Pure Spirit of Fantasy, Little Dread, the Fake Red Moon, which is actually the playmat art, so I really, really like this card. Magic Stone Flame, and we've got Alice's World. Let's think of Bobby's World. Mad Tea Party, Red Bird of Omen, The Queen's Butler, Brainless Scarecrow, Card Soldier Heart, Demon's Curse, Rena the Girl with Nothing, Grim Avenger of Fairy Tales, Magic Stone of Light, Queen of Hearts. We're going into almost 20 minutes here. Katarina of the Saint of Fantasy, Realm of Pure Spirits, The Queen's Butler, Brandless Scarecrow, Card Soldier Heart, Demon's Curse, Green of the Girl with Nothing, Grim the Avenger of Fairy Tales once again, and Lumitel, Tower of Hope. Alrighty, so after this pack, I'm just gonna be showing, like, I'm gonna be still showing the cards, but not saying the names. I'm gonna go a little bit faster. Nadehart, Demon Knight, Oz the Great Wizard, because I think we've already seen all the cards in the set. Shallows, Giant Dolphin, March of Saints, Portal of Truth, Whisper from the Abyss, Big Bang Revolution, Guardia, the Guardian Dragon of Heaven, I believe. Let me tell. Alright, so for these couple packs, I'm just going to open them and not say what the cards are unless they have not been shown or they are rares or whatnot. So, Magic Stone, let me tell. So it seems like there's kind of a pattern to some of the cards. Like every single time I get a Big Bang Revolution in a pack, I end up getting I end up getting the Portal of Truth and Whisper from the Abyss in the same pack so far, from what I'm seeing. Okay, never mind. Another Magic Stone. So many Magic Stones. This is Dorothy the Lost Girl. I don't know if I reset it, but just in case. There we go. Yep, it happened again. Realm of the Dragon King. So yeah, as you see, I get these three in the same pack almost every single time. Like, if I see one of them, I kind of end up seeing the other two in there. It's just a very, very big coincidence. Rifard, the Castle in Heaven. I hate that card. Because someone uses it to beat me a lot with it, so they kill me pretty much with that card. Another Yamata no Orochi. Today. Two more packs. We're almost there, guys. We're almost there. Alright, there we go. So, Portal of Truth, Whisper from the Abyss, Big Bang Revolution. Yeah, so far in this box, yeah, those three come together. Joan of Arc, basically Joan d'Arc, The Awakening Purity. This is a good Joan of Arc, because there's also a mean one that destroys all humans. And it's a ruler. This one's not a ruler, but the other one is. So, just so you guys know, for information's sake, what I found out is that you get, in this set, the second set, yay, another little dread. In this set, the second one, you basically get two rulers per box. That's like the average. Maybe you can get more, but I don't know. As far as I know, you only get two rulers per box, and because in this set there's only one ruler per color. However, in the first set, Crimson Moon's Fairy Tale, that one there's actually two rulers per color, so you actually end up getting four rulers per box in that one. So if you're looking to get into the game and getting some rulers, don't really care which ones, as long as you know you get a decent amount to start off, I'd probably suggest you buy the Crimson Moon's Fairy Tale, as that said before, so you can get some ruler options from there, and then get working with that. Also, another thing to notice is that this set and Crimson Moon's Fairy Tale have different dual stones in them. So for example, Crimson Moon's Fairy Tale has the black red one. This one doesn't have that, it has the black blue one. So, you know, so if you're actually looking to buying boxes or packs from these sets, I suggest you do some research on what cards you're looking for to ensure that you get the cards that you're looking for. Once again, I appreciate you guys sticking by the whole 24 minutes, 25, whatever it's going to be, of watching this booster box opening. I really enjoyed it. I plan on doing more booster box openings for Force of Will. So once again, thank you. Please comment, subscribe, like this video, share it, you know, let people know. In my local shops, Force of Will sold out within like 2 weeks. So it seems like it's very promising. If you like Magic, if you like Yu-Gi-Oh, if you like Vanguard, it has an element of all of those. If you don't like one of those, don't worry, because there are still a lot of elements from the other ones to actually make up for it. It fixes, it has a system to, I guess, counter being mana stuck, or having too much mana, or not enough mana. So yeah, I definitely suggest you check out this card game. Once again, thank you. This is Chewy from ATX TCG, signing out.